Today, we're gonna completely understand what is curves, and I guarantee you that you'll fall in love with this tool in Snapseed or any other photo editing application, either in PC or in mobile. So, without any further ado, let's get started. Here, there's no adjustment layers in Snapseed. However, there is. You can make certain changes to the curves by going into Stacks Brush, which is at the top, then View Edits, and then click on the curves that you want to edit. Also, you can make changes to the curves directly in Lightroom Mobile. Here's how. I'll apply the traditional S curve. I'll talk about it later in this video. Then apply some filters. Still, you can make changes to the S-curve that you did just a while back. First of all, why this line is always diagonal? Why it cannot be horizontal or vertical? The reason is simple. Assume borders as the wall. You cannot make anything which is absolute black blacker. Making sense? If the curves were horizontal or vertical, you could move the darkest part even more dark, which makes no sense at all. Absolute black means there's nothing darker than that, right? I hope now it's making sense to you. And the same applies to the white as well. You cannot make anything which is white even more whiter. And that's why it is kept at the roof or at the top on the right hand side, and black is kept at the bottom on the left hand side. And that's why it is kept diagonal. Now, let's start with the curves. I'll use Snapseed for your better understanding. Later you can apply the same concepts in Lightroom as well. Let's create a curve adjustment layer by tapping on the tools. Then curves are extremely simple. All you need to understand is these two simple words, the bright and the dark. Yeah, these two simple words. The right side on the curves represents the bright pixels and the left side represents the dark pixels. Going up in the curves makes it brighter or adds, and similarly, coming down makes it dark or subtracts. In other words, sides right and up makes the pixels bright, and sides left and down makes the pixels dark. As simple as that. In order to make the bright pixels brighter, we gotta take the help of a corresponding line in this tool. This diagonal line. I'll make a point on the brighter side and bring it up, as easy as that. Now, in order to make the dark pixels darker, let's make a point on the darker part, that is left, and bring it down as much as needed. And this is the traditional classic S curve, and that's what contrast is. It makes the brighter pixels brighter and the darker pixels darker. This is the before and here's the after. Now, if you want to reset the curves, then all you have to do is simple. Move the points that you tapped on the screen before you draw either up or down to the very end. Let's say you want to make the dark pixels brighter. So, what should you do? First, let's make a point on the darker side on the curves. Then simply bring it up. When you see, it's making the brighter part brighter as well. And I don't want that to happen. And it's visible on this diagonal line here. So, just make a point on this curve then bring it down to normalize the pixels that became brighter. Further, the midsection here in this curve represents the midtones. I'll talk about it later in the part of this video. Before we move on, you gotta know about the colors. RGB is opposite of CMY. I'll expand. Red is the opposite of cyan, green is the opposite of magenta, and blue is the opposite of yellow. I said this because there are three channels in curves here, R, G, and B tones. Let's start with red channel by tapping on it over here. And the same theory applies over here as well. Remember, it's universal. If you want to make the brighter pixels more reddish, or let's say you want to add more red to the highlights, make a point on the brighter part, which is on the right hand side, and then move it up as we did before. Remember, moving up adds and moving down subtracts. If you bring the red down, then it will subtract the red and it adds cyan, because red is the opposite of cyan. And the same applies to the other colors as well. For example, let's go to the green channel by clicking on the green channel and bring the green all the way to the down. It adds magenta because magenta is the opposite of green, and that's what we applied now. You have seen some of the PiXinCreate's previous videos having faded black images, right? Let's see how it works. Let me reset it first. And the way how the faded works is making the extreme black areas a little bit brighter by bringing it up just like this to create a faded look. Suppose you need to add some blues to the shadows. So click on the blue channel, then bring the darker pixels on the left hand side a little up. That was simple, right? Now let's move deeper into the curves. When you touch on the curves on the screen, you are making a matrix visible, which is appearing on the screen right now. You can even move the curves horizontally like this. And these are scaled from 0 to 255. Here you have 0, which is absolute black, and in the middle of the matrix you have 128, which is 50% gray, and on the right hand side it is 255, which is 100% pure white. And the same is applicable to the vertical side as well, I mean the y-axis, 0 to 255. If you want to adjust the midtones, just make a point on the middle of the diagonal and move it either towards up to brighten or down to darken it. The reason why I said about the pixel values is that you can play with those values in Photoshop on your PC. But of course, the principles are universal. Here, you don't have any option to modify the curves by changing the absolute value or absolute pixel. So, I'll leave the topic here. Further, you can see the histogram over here, which shows us that these many pixels exist in that area. In this image, the darker part has more pixels than the other. So that will help us in making the composites even more easier by targeting the pixels directly. And in some other cases, there will be no brighter pixels reaching 255. That is, the brightest pixel is less than the value 255. In that case, you will see no changes in the image until you touch the outermost pixel when using the curves. By doing so, it will allow you to pop the images easily as well. One last tip for this video. Suppose you want to invert the color. Usually, what a normal person would do is that he or she would use double exposure in Snapseed to add a black image and blend it by using some subtract or any other option, thereby complicating it. What if I show you the easiest one step way to invert the colors using curves, huh? I'll just reset it. Now, bring the point which is on the rightmost end, and it is at 255 to 0, absolute black. Now you have converted the entire image to black. Then move the point which is on the leftmost end to 255, which is white, and that's it. But make sure that you have selected RGB instead of luminance, as it would only invert the black and white instead of every color. I hope that you found this video useful and made it possible for you to explore more about the curves. And if it does, leave a like and make sure you do subscribe to PiXinCreate, and don't forget to ring the bell so that you don't miss any of the future tips, tricks or tutorials. Lastly, this is Pawan and you're watching PiXinCreate, and I'll see you in the next one. Till then, have fun with learning.